being a writer is that it is just fun. It's fun to sit down, make up stories, and then imagine. And basically, it's almost like the story writes itself.
We've only just begun to live white lace and promises, a kiss for luck and we're on our way.
We've only begun.
Question. For Columbia News, I'm Janet McDonald.
A bunch of upwardly mobile athletes did something yesterday that even King Kong never tried. They ran up the stairs of the Empire State Building. Kei Kusuda has the story.
One thing I always did was write. Even growing up when I was, you know, 9, 10, 11, I remember, I think because I was in the projects, I had all these brothers and sisters around me. There were three girls in one room and three boys in the other room. My youngest brother came much later. I always felt crowded and like I didn't have any privacy. I didn't have any place to go and be alone. And so I think I would go to places in my head to just be left alone. And I would write things like little stories, or sometimes I would just make lists of things I wanted to buy when I grew up. In fact, it's funny because I found one of those lists recently. And it was this little piece of paper that said, things to buy when grown. I wrote it when I was 12 years old. I was like, hello, what kind of 12-year-old was I? The first thing on the list is banjo. I hate banjos. I hate banjo music. I like guitars, but for some reason, I wanted to buy a banjo. I had pizza on the list, which hasn't changed because I'm always ordering pizza. It was just funny, some binoculars. Best things about law school are getting admitted, because it's very difficult to get admitted, and when you do, you're very happy. And graduating, because you're very happy to leave once you put in your 3 years. What I like most about being a lawyer is the money. Just kidding.
If you think the days of Thurgood Marshall becoming the first African-American Supreme Court justice are long gone, consider the modern-day story of Janet McDonald. Ms. McDonald is the only African-American woman admitted to the Paris Bar. That's Paris, France. She is the only one, and she's written a book about that experience and then some. It's called Project Girl. And Janet McDonald joins us now to talk about her book and her many achievements. And Janet McDonald, thank you so much for coming here today. Let's talk. You moved all the way to France to achieve your dreams here. Is it truthful to say in France there's no discrimination, that we don't have any of these obstacles, and that's why I'm practicing law in France?
Well, France is a whole different world than here, obviously. And I majored in French in college, and I loved Paris. I went there on junior year abroad. And I found that African Americans are welcomed in Paris and in France in a way that I wasn't used to here.
Why is that?
I think because in France, race is not the defining factor of a person.